As the world becomes more connected, cybersecurity becomes increasingly important. One tool that is commonly used to protect computer systems from cyber attacks is a firewall. In this video, we'll explore what is a firewall, the different types of firewalls, and the various ways in which firewalls can be deployed. So, let's get started. First off, what is a firewall? Well, a firewall is a security tool that monitors and controls incoming and outgoing network traffic. It acts as a barrier between a private internal network and the public internet, preventing unauthorized access to the network and protecting it from cyber attacks. Firewalls are designed to detect and block malicious traffic while allowing legitimate traffic to pass through. For this, they use a set of rules to determine whether to allow or block traffic based on various factors such as the source and destination of the traffic, the type of traffic, and the content of traffic. Next, let's discuss the types of firewalls. Well, there are several types of firewalls, each with its own unique way of filtering network traffic. Let's take a look at some of the most common types of firewalls. Starting with number 1, packet filtering firewalls. So, packet filtering firewalls are the simplest and the most common type of firewall. They examine each packet of data, inspecting information such as destination and origination of IP address, packet type, port number, and other surface level details without opening the packet to examine its content that enters or leaves the network and compare it against a set of rules defined previously. Now, if the packet matches the rules, it is allowed to pass through, otherwise it is blocked. The good thing about these firewalls is that they aren't very resource intensive, and by using fewer resources means they are relatively simple and don't significantly impact system performance. However, they are also relatively easy to bypass compared to firewalls with more robust inspection capabilities. Next, circuit level gateways. So, circuit level gateways are another simplistic firewall type meant to quickly and easily approve or deny traffic without consuming significant computing resources. They operate at the transport layer of the network and monitor the TCP handshake process between connections. While these are extremely resource efficient, these firewalls do not check the packet itself. So, if a packet held malware but had the proper TCP handshake, it would easily pass through. Vulnerabilities like this are the reasons why circuit level gateways are not enough to protect your data completely. Next, stateful inspection firewalls. Now, stateful inspection firewalls combine packet inspection technology and TCP handshake verification to create a more significant level of protection than either of the architecture could provide alone. So, they not only examine each packet of data but also keep track of the state of connections. This allows them to block traffic that is part of any unauthorized connection network. However, although the security strength is higher now, these firewalls also put more strain on computing resources, which may result in the transfer slowdown of legitimate packets compared to other solutions. Next, application level gateways, which are also known as proxy firewalls. So, these operate at the application layer of the network. These firewalls are usually delivered via cloud-based solution or another proxy device, and rather than letting traffic connect directly, the proxy firewall first establishes a connection to the source of the traffic and inspects each incoming data packet. This check is similar to the stateful inspection firewall in looking at both the packet and the TCP handshake protocol. However, proxy firewalls also perform deep layer packet inspection, checking the actual contents of the information packet to verify that it contains no malware. This inspection of the contents of each packet of data promotes security and can block traffic that does not meet a certain criteria. They also act as a mediator between clients and servers, which inherently improves performance and security. The one drawback to proxy firewalls is that they can create a significant slowdown because of the extra steps in the data packet transfer process. Next that we have is the next generation firewalls. Now, these firewalls are also known as intelligent firewalls, as these can perform all tasks that are performed by other types of firewalls that we just learned previously. But on top of that, it offers additional features like application awareness and control, integrated intrusion prevention, and cloud-delivered threat intelligence, etc. Further, they can identify and block a wide range of cyber threats, including malware and phishing attacks as well. Next, let's discuss the types of firewall deployment architecture. Well, firewalls can be deployed in a variety of ways, depending on the need of the organization. Let's take a look at some of the most common deployment architectures in this video. Starting with number one, software firewalls. Now, software firewalls are installed on individual devices such as laptops, desktops, and servers. They provide protection for a single device and are commonly used in small businesses and home networks. These include any type of firewall that is installed on a local device rather than a separate piece of hardware or a cloud server. The big benefit of software firewall is that it's highly useful for creating defense in depth by isolating individual network endpoints from one another. However, maintaining individual software firewalls on different devices can be difficult and time-consuming. Furthermore, not every device on the network may be compatible with a single software firewall, which may mean having to use several different software firewalls to cover every asset. Next, hardware firewalls. These include dedicated devices that are installed at the network perimeter and provide protection for the entire network while handling a large volume of traffic. Hardware firewalls use a physical appliance that acts like a traffic router to intercept data packets and traffic requests before they are connected to the network server. Physical appliance-based firewalls like this excel at perimeter security by ensuring malicious traffic from the outside of the network are intercepted before the company's network endpoints are exposed to risk. But do note that hardware firewalls can be more expensive than software firewalls, as they provide better performance and scalability. Further, the major weakness of a hardware-based firewall is that it is often easy for insider attacks to bypass them. Also, the actual capabilities of any hardware firewall may vary depending on its manufacturer, as some may have more capacity to handle simultaneous connections than others. That's why conducting a thorough check is important before going forward with implementation. Next, cloud firewalls. First of all, whenever you're using a cloud solution to deliver a firewall, it can be called as a cloud firewall or firewall as a service or FaaS. These cloud firewalls are similar to hardware firewalls, but instead are hosted in the cloud. They provide protection for cloud-based applications and services and can be easily scaled up or down depending on the demand. The primary benefit of having cloud-based firewalls is that they are straightforward to scale with your organization. As your need grows, you can add additional capacity to your cloud server to filter larger traffic loads. Also, never forget that cloud firewalls, just like hardware firewalls, excel at perimeter security. Lastly, in conclusion, I'd like to say that in today's interconnected world, firewalls are an essential tool for protecting computer systems from cyber threats. There are several types of firewalls, each with its own unique way of filtering network traffic, and accordingly, firewalls can be deployed in a variety of ways, depending on the needs of the organization. Further, it is important to note that while firewalls are an effective security tool, they are not a comprehensive solution for cybersecurity. They should be used in conjunction with other security measures such as antivirus software, intrusion detection systems, and security policies and procedures. In addition, it is important to keep firewalls up to date with the latest security patches and updates to ensure that they can effectively protect against new and evolving cyber threats. With that, I hope this video was helpful to you and served value. If you love my content, feel free to smash that like button. And if you haven't already subscribed to my channel, please do, as it keeps me motivated and helps me create more content like this for you.